Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common BMW S85 engine problems. The BMW S85 is a 5-liter naturally aspirated V10 engine produced from 2005 until 2010 and is found predominantly in the E60 M5 as well as the E63 M6. The S85 V10 is a very unique BMW engine in a number of different ways. It was the first V10 production engine ever built by BMW and actually to this day remains still the only production V10 engine that BMW has ever built. Additionally, the S85, unlike many other BMW M engines, is actually not based on any other production engines. The S85 was a unique design of its own. Now, it is important to mention the S65 V8 engine was later based on the S85 V10, so the S65 did essentially build off of the S85 and share a lot of that same design. The 5-liter V10 pumps out 500 horsepower, 384 foot-pounds of torque, and revs to a whopping 8,250 RPMs. 100 horsepower per liter from a naturally aspirated engine, again 500 horsepower from a 5-liter V10 engine, is still very impressive even as of 2024, and was even more impressive back during the introduction of the S85 in 2005. So ultimately, a very impressive performance engine, and even to this day, the S85 is still a very powerful and capable engine. However, it does come with a few downsides, and that is reliability and a couple common problems that can be rather expensive and a hassle on the S85. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common BMW S85 engine problems. Number one on the list, we have rod bearing failures. I do want to point this out up front. Rod bearing failures, to some extent, are blown out of proportion on the internet. It's not hard to find a ton of horror stories and information about the S85 and rod bearing failures leading to complete engine failure and very expensive repair bills. However, this is still something to be aware of. Just because rod bearing failure is very severe, it can often take out the entire engine with it, or at least cause additional damage to components like the crankshaft and require a new crankshaft, if not caught in time. Some people recommend preventatively replacing the rod bearings every roughly 50 to 80,000 miles. This isn't a terrible idea. However, sometimes the rod bearings can and do last quite a bit longer than that. So one thing that you can do is do an oil analysis on the car. Companies like Blackstone Laboratories offer oil analysis kits, which you can pick up for fairly cheap to have the oil analyzed. And the results will ultimately tell you if there are certain metals found in the oil and specifically if there's any metal coming from the rod bearings that would indicate premature bearing wear. As a final note with rod bearing failure, if this is done preventatively or caught in time and you replace the bearings before any additional damage, it will typically be a roughly $2,000 to $3,000 job, including parts and labor. So fairly expensive, but ultimately that is a lot cheaper than, again, if the bearings actually do end up failing and potentially taking out the entire engine. That could lead to a complete engine replacement or very severe costly repair bills that could exceed $7,000 to $10,000. So ultimately, it is good to replace those ahead of time to prevent further damage to the engine. Moving on to the second common problem, we have the throttle actuators. So the S85 actually uses 10 individual throttle bodies, one throttle body for each cylinder, and then in turn to control each of those individual throttle bodies, the engine uses two throttle actuators, one on each bank of the engine. The throttle actuators are another issue that tends to be a fairly common issue and something that tends to pop up in that roughly 60,000 to 100,000 mile ballpark. There are two main failure points with the throttle actuators. Number one is the plastic gears inside. Over time, those plastic gears simply degrade, wear down, and can end up breaking and causing issues with the throttle actuators. And then the second common problem is actually the circuit boards can electronically fail inside the actuators. Now, one thing with this issue is, unfortunately, it is a pretty expensive issue to actually fix. Each actuator runs from about $400 to $800 each, depending on what you buy, whether that be genuine BMW, rebuilt options, or any sort of aftermarket options. and then labor will come in around $500 to $1,000. So if you end up in there replacing both throttle actuators, you could very well be looking at a repair bill in the ballpark of about $1,500 to $2,000 plus dollars. Moving on to common problem number three, we have the SMG transmission. It is known to be a problematic point on the M5 and M6. SMG stands for sequential manual gearbox. When the SMG transmission was initially introduced here in the United States in the early 2000s, it was actually an excellent transmission, one that was highly advanced for its time. However, unfortunately, the SMG quickly became outdated. There are actually a number of different common faults and failures within the sequential manual gearbox. The most common of those are problems with the hydraulic pump motor, and a couple other common issues to look out for with the SMG transmission include the clutch sensor and the pressure accumulator. All three of these parts are all $500 plus dollars each, and a lot of the times working on these SMG transmissions and actually fixing the issue will result in labor costs of about $500 to $1,000 plus dollars. If you run into any one of these problems, expect a repair bill in the ballpark of $1,000 to $2,000 plus dollars, potentially more if you have multiple issues going on within the SMG transmission or it needs a more complete rebuild and overhaul. When the SMG is working well, it still is a good transmission. It's just a little bit outdated and not quite as capable as modern transmissions, and also known to be a little bit more problematic, unfortunately. So ultimately, those three problems are the three main problems with the BMW S85 V10 engine and the BMW M5 and M6. However, I did have a couple other minor issues and age-related things. We have valve cover gasket oil leaks, issues with the idle control valve, as well as the PCV or positive crankcase ventilation system. The main point of this is to talk about the fact that the S85 is a high-performance engine, roughly 15 to 20-year-old. With that kind of age and the kind of mileage that is on quite a few of these engines nowadays, all sorts of issues are fair game. Things like gaskets, O-rings, hoses, really any rubber or rubber-like components are prone to degradation and wearing down. Even just with age outside of mileage, age can be just as tough on these rubber or rubber-like components. And again, top that off with the fact that we are talking about a very high-performance V10 engine here, and the S85 is already going to be more expensive to upkeep and maintain and repair than your average performance car or engine. And so all of that does combine to make the S85, M5, and M6 rather expensive to own and keep up with. And so just something to keep in mind, if you are in the market for a BMW S85, they're not terribly unreliable engines. However, they are brought down a little bit by a few costly issues like the SMG transmission, rod bearings, and throttle actuators, and sometimes those costs can be overwhelming. When you combine those common problems with a couple other repair bills and just general higher maintenance costs on the engine, the S85 can quickly become a little overwhelming and very expensive to own and maintain. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.